Hey, what's going on, Travis Red again, just hitting you guys with another video. If you're new to my channel, welcome. So guys, I'm just going to hit you guys up with another reading. This is a general reading, and it's a timeless read, so whenever you come across this video, it's going to be for you. Alright, so let's begin. Alright, so your first card is gratitude, and what I'm getting from this card is if you're feeling your vibrations feeling kind of low, try writing a gratitude list to be grateful for what you've got, and because showing gratitude it's also helps you bring more blessings into your life, being grateful. Because when you're already grateful for what you already have, you seem to attract more of it. Like, when you start being grateful for the things that you have, you start to attract more. Interesting. And some of you is gonna be hearing about pregnancy soon, is what I'm getting for that as well. And something's beginning to bloom for some of you guys. Is what I'm getting for that card. And there may be love in the air as well, I'm getting as well, with the heart at the top. Moving on. So impasse. What I get for this card is some of you may feel blocked, or your path may be having some obstacles on. If your path is got obstacles on, that's a good thing. Because they're challenges, so don't see them as I'm feeling blocked and I can't do this. Just see it as more of a challenge, because if a road hasn't got any obstacles down, the road probably doesn't lead to anywhere. And what I get from this card is some of you need to go outside and be in nature and do some grounding as well. I don't know, I'm just getting called to his feet and the trees in the background. But yeah, some of you are feeling blocked, or some of you may have sacral chakra blockages as well, because these are chakra cards. So yeah, some of you may be experiencing some blockage in your sacral chakra, and that will be stopping your creativity. Okay, moving on, guys. Okay, soulmate. So what I get from this is some of you may already be on the twin flame journey, and experiencing some difficulties. If you're experiencing some difficulties in separation, just work on yourself, concentrate on yourself, and find out where you want to be, what you want from life, and start showing yourself some unconditional love as well. Because once you can fully love yourself, that's when you're ready to kind of fully love someone else as well, if that makes sense. Because if you're getting into a relationship, you're meant to be giving the other person like half of you. So if you're already at 50% and you've got to give someone half of 50, you're going to be running on 25%. So before getting into a relationship, you should be looking to be at least, I don't know, 75% healed maybe, or aware of your flaws and stuff. Because if you're already on 75%, if you've got to give them half of that, then you're still going to have a decent amount to work with, and you're not going to be running on empty. You'll still have energy for yourself, if that makes sense. Moving on. Destiny. So what I get from this is some of you are going to be, your spiritual gifts are going to be waking up, and you're going to be more in tune with source and getting more downloads, and things are going to be coming into balance, like the yin and yang, the black and white, in and out, light versus dark. And some of you, your spirit guides and angels are trying to communicate with you. And some of you are very old souls, you've been here many times before. And some of you, your a passed over loved one is one of your spirit guides, or is a part of your spirit team, should I say. So if this is so, you should communicate with your angels always, but if they're a family member, then communicate with them as well. If you miss them, tell them that you miss them, and they can communicate back with you. Moving on. Dissipating. Okay. So some of you may be kind of contemplating your next move, planning stuff. Or some of you are just going through like a hermit mode, kind of just lounging around, maybe watching TV. Some of you may have a bird. But if you are in the kind of hermit kind of mode, use this time to kind of plan some goals, is what I've been telling to tell you guys. Plan some goals, but obviously if you need time out because you're feeling burnt out or doing some inner work in this hermit mode, should I say, be kind to yourself. Don't beat yourself up for being burnt out or wanting to take time out for yourself, because time out for yourself is a form of self-love as well, so that's also great. Okay, and what I get from this card is rejection. So some of you may be experiencing a lot of negative thoughts, but what I'm seeing here is these negative thoughts are not yours. You've got basically any G cords attached to you, and you're feeding off, someone else is feeding off your energy, and you're picking up on their energy with the ghost around him, is what I'm getting, because it's quite gloomy outside, like in the windows, it's quite grey, should I say. So do some energy clearing, guys. Do some cord cutting meditations. You can find them on YouTube. And protect your energy more is what I'm getting for that. Or some of you also may be getting downloads, and your spirit guides are trying to connect with you as well, because this is like the crown chakra card. And what I'm getting from this as well is some of you may be feeling rejected from a certain situation. And if you are feeling rejected from a certain situation, that means that road and that path isn't for you, and your angels and guides are protecting you from a road that you shouldn't be going down. So if you have been feeling rejected, look at it as more redirection, should I say. Moving on. And your next card is trickery. So what I get from this is someone is lying to you. They may be all sweet in your face is what I'm getting. But behind your back, they could be gossiping about you. So keep your, from what I get from this, is someone's wearing a false mask. So be careful who you tell a lot of your personal business to, because some people, they want to see you doing they want to see you doing good, but not better than them, should I say. So keep your ideas. It's all right to talk with people and stuff, but don't be telling people your plans and your moves is what I'm getting, because someone's wearing a false mask and someone's lying in a situation, whether it's a friend, family member, romantic interest. Yeah, someone's wearing a false mask and someone's lying. There's trickery, or someone's trying to trick you somehow. So be careful. Say for instance, someone wants to borrow money or something, I'm getting from you. Don't do it, because they're not going to pay you back for some reason is what I'm getting. So yeah, I'm trying to, and acceptance. So some of you will be going through an acceptance, like accepting situations for what they are, or accepting yourself more. And some of you's maybe accepting some of you are getting, maybe accepting a loved one that's passed over is what I'm getting, because the women don't seem too happy, and she seems to be right. Maybe some of you are writing about your thoughts and feelings at the moment, Some of you have got your angels around you, guiding and protecting you. Someone may like cherries as well, or be eating cherries right now. Or got cherries on the mind. but yeah, some of you may be accepting yourself for who you are and knowing that you're different and unique, just coming into that maybe. Or accepting certain situations for what they are, they truly are, is what I'm getting. Moving on. And vanity. All right. Vanity is not always a bad card, because sometimes vanity can be like a good form of confidence and a good form of self-love. So maybe some of you need to work on your confidence a bit, but vanity is not always a bad thing. So if you get a new tracksuit or a new outfit and you put it on and you think, yeah, I look good in that, like, you should feel good in it because you bought it, and you wear the clothes, don't wear your clothes, wear you, you know. But don't overdo it if you're being vain. Yeah, it's all good being vain, like, yeah, I look good and I know it and I'm going to show that. But you know, some people will be clapped, walking around clapped and that, and they thinking they look good, and it's like, dude, you don't even look good, bruv. Like, so so and some of you are like to be center of attention is what I'm getting, or like to stand out. And also some of you are wearing an amethyst crystal right now as well. And some of you need to sage your energy down, because if you're around too many people, you're going to start absorbing their energy, whether you're at parties or social gatherings and stuff, is what I'm getting for that card. And that's your last card for that reading, guys. And that's, usually I would go off the center card being the main card, but because they're chakra cards, you got two red cards. So that would indicate to me some of you need to work on your root chakra and get grounded more. And you can use black crystals, any grounding crystal, to kind of ground yourself during this time as well. But yeah, that's your reading, guys. If you like the video, like, share, subscribe, hit the comments below, and you guys can also add me on Instagram if you guys are watching. My Instagram's open, so you guys can check that out. But peace, love and light, tribe. I'm gonna hit you guys up real soon.